إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, Al-Khaliq, Al-Raziq, Al-Muhi, Al-Mumit. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him all the time. And we seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him, and whomever misguided, no one will guide him. I bear witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. Brother and sister in Islam, we thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we do takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, in the Eid, showing the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so He give us so much ni'mah, so much bounty. Bless us with this bounty. So we say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And also one of the greatest ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, the Islam. Give us the Iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of also the ni'am, great ni'mah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send us Al-Quran as a guidance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inform us in the Quran how to save yourself from the punishment of Allah and how to save yourself from the hellfire and how to go in the way of light, the way of Iman, the way of guidance. As we are in the series of Sifatu Ahli Al-Jannah, the attribute and the character of the people of Al-Jannah, the people of heaven, the people of paradise. Today, by the will of Allah, we're going to talk about the character number 16. Character number 16. They used to have amazing Sifat, amazing character, amazing attribute. Let's find out the character of the people of Jannah. So because of this characteristic, they achieve the blessing and permanent blessing, Al-Jannah, heaven and paradise and shurga. We thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among of them. The character today we're going to talk about, Al-Khawfu Minan Nar. Al-Khawfu Minan Nar. The people of Al-Jannah, they used to be afraid and scared and aware from the hell fire. The people of Al-Jannah, they used to be scared and afraid and aware from the hell fire. Because of this character, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them, that Allah will save them from the hell fire, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them permanent, pleasant, Al-Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us as Allah gather us in dunya, okay, in this class, in this lesson. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us in Al-Jannah. Today the topic is very touching. It's not over imagination, it's a reality. Based of Al-Quran and the Hadith. Let's start with a small clip giving you an introduction about the hellfire, how it's extremely pain and extremely bad and evil place. May Allah save us and protect us from it. Bismillah. اللهم أجرنا من النار ومن حر النار
منيخة الأرجاء، مظلمة المسالك، مبهمة المهالك.
كل الخوف اللي في الدنيا ده مش خوف، الخوف الحقيقي يوم ما تشوف جهنم.
Sheikh, he's saying that starting with a dua, oh Allah save us from the hellfire, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the punishment of hellfire. Sheikh, he said, oh who is doing the sin and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are unaware about the hellfire, wake up, because the hellfire, it's extremely pain and extremely nobody can handle the pain of the hellfire. Sheikh, he said, there is no fearness, there is no real fear or real afraid. The real afraid when the people see the hellfire, and the real fear when the people wal'iyadhu billah throwing in the hellfire. This is the real fear. Whatever we are afraid of fear from this dunya, nothing compared from this moment with ayyadhu billah when the people being seeing the hellfire in front of them and they going to be dragging and throwing in it.
سبعون ألف زمام، على كل زمام سبعون ألف ملك يجرونها، فتصفر زفرة.
اللهم ارحمنا إذا زفرت النار يا ذا الجلال والإكرام.
فيجيب حينئذ وتزهر كل مرضعة عما أرضعت حين سمع
يوم القيامة. The hellfire will be ordered to brought. So how they will brought the hellfire? The hellfire, it has 70 ألف زمام, 70,000 chain. 70,000 chain. Every chain need 70,000 angel to hold and bringing the hellfire. When they bring the hellfire, may Allah save us and protect us. فَتَزْفُرُوا زَفْرَةً. That means the hellfire give inhale and exhale. You know, when take breath and you know release the breath. So the hellfire will release some of the breath. Because of that releasing, the hellfire, the angels will doesn't have the ability to control it. So what will happen? فَحِينَ إِذٍ يُصْبِحُ الْوِلْدَانُ شِيبًا. In that moment, in that situation, the children, their hair will be white hair, out of terror and out of fearness and out of afraid. Can you imagine a child, he has a black hair out of scaredness and fearness, when the hellfire will give exhale or give breath out. So what will happen? His hair become white. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن هذا حجر ألقي في جهنم منذ 70 خريفا لم يصل إلى قعرها إلا الآن.
الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, in one moment the Sahaba hear very high sound or very high like shaking, like they hear something very extremely sound. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told them, do you know what is this? He said, Allah and His Messenger know better. He said, this is a stone been throwing in the hellfire from 70,000 years ago, and now reach the lowest level in the hellfire. Can you imagine how deep and strong that hellfire? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us.
مش ناركم هذا نار البوتاجاز والكلام ده، لا، أقصى درجة حرارة يمكن أن يتخيلها العقل في الدنيا هذا جزء من 70 جزءا من نار جهنم.
In the hadith of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم he said ناركم هذه your fire this it's a part of 70 parts of the hellfire. That means that the hellfire it's multiply more than 70 times in pain than the normal fire. And the Sheikh he explained not the fire of the gas or the fire the one we use, the highest level of heat, the one in dunya we can see it or analyze it 70 times more. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us.
لو كانت كنار الدنيا لكفت.
يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يلقى على أهل النار الجوع فيستغيثون فيغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه.
ماء بلغ أوانه في شدة الحرارة.
لما يستغيثوا فيدلهم ميه. يجوا يشربوا الميه مجرد ما يقرب الميه من فمه الصهد بتاع الميه يشوي.
ولكن هيشرب حتى وان سقط لحم الوجه يتجرعه ولا يكاد يسيغه.
الشيخ talking about the people in hellfire, may Allah save us and protect us. They will start starving, hungry. Okay, and they also thirsty. So when they are thirsty, they looking for water, they will be brought to them a water. So just that water come closer to their face will melt. Their face will melt. Not that خلاص, his face already melt. No, he been forced to drink it. وَالْعَذُ بِاللَّهِ. Then he will drink it وَالْعَذُ بِاللَّهِ, with a full of pain. And all inside internal organ will be melt again and come out from his body. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us from this punishment of the hellfire.
يوم القيامة ماشية كيف تتمشى في الآخرة يأتون وعلى ظهورهم أحمال تكسر الظهور من الذنوب أمثال الجبال قالوا يجرون أغلالهم.
أول ما يمس النار من البدن الوجه
فهو الله للنار عذابا. رجل يدعي نعلين من نار يغلي منهما دماغه.
Sheikh, the people when they being brought, the people of hellfire will be brought yawm al-qiyamah, they carrying their sin, their ma'asir, their dhunub, their mistakes, their shortcoming, they will carry it as a mountain over their head, over their shoulder, over their back. Mountains over their back, they will carry it and they walk. And the first things would hit them in the hellfire, their faces. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us. It's extremely painful. May Allah protect us.
رجل يخرج من النار ويدخل الجنة. رجل يدعو الله تبارك وتعالى ويقول يا رب لقد أحرقني ذكاؤها وقشبني ريحها فأخرجني منها. فأخرجه من النار ثم تغلق النار أبوابها ولا يبقى في النار إلا أهلها الذين هم أهلها.
أيها الحبيب.
The last person will come out from the hellfire. He will ask Allah, Ya Allah, protect me, save me, the fire burned me. And the smell of fire also burned me and scratched me. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let him go out. When he come out from the hellfire, the hellfire will be locked and never open again. And only whom the people of hellfire will be remaining there forever. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us.
فإن النار جحيم مسعر لا ينجو منه إلا أهل الإيمان.
اللهم باعد بيننا وبين النار كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب. اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار.
فمن زحزح عن النار وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ.
اللَّهُمَّ اعْتِقْ رِقَابَنَا مِنَ النَّارِ.
So, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. So be aware, Be in fear towards the hellfire. Whomever pushed away or moved away from the hellfire and he entered Jannah or she entered Jannah, فَقَدْ فَاز. فَقَدْ فَاز. What is mean faz? Faz mean he get or he achieve the highest winning. He achieved the highest winning. He's the winner. He is the winner. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among of الفائزين في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين في الدنيا والآخرة. Brothers and sisters in Islam, talking about the hellfire, something is very emotional and very touching. And subhanAllah, I don't know how to talk about this. Something over our imagination. But according the word of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah, it's a good to remind us, remind ourselves, remind myself, in order to fear and afraid from the hellfire, in order to achieve al-Jannah and to be saved from the hellfire in the next life. So that is a Sunnah. That's the way of Sahaba radiallahu anhum. They used to be fear and scared and afraid from the hellfire, because Allah described it in Al-Holy Quran. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, he also described it in many, many ahadith, showing how much the hellfire, it's extremely painful and punishment. Nobody can handle it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us. Not like the Jews, he said, وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَا النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَةً. The Jews, he said, وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَا. They said, the hellfire only can touch us one day or couple of days. Then Allah replied to them, and Allah said to them, قُلْ أَتَّخَذْتُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَهْدًا فَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ عَهْدًا. Do you think you have a guaranteed from Allah that you will not go to hellfire only day, one day or few days? وَلَنْ يُخْلِفَ اللَّهُ عَهْدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever Allah says, that the hellfire for disbeliever, who will be disbeliever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forever, khalidina fiha, that will be truly fulfilled. Truly fulfilled. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us. Let's analyze some of the verses, okay, talking about this character. The character of the people of Jannah, they used to be in dunya fear and aware from the hellfire. Not like some of the people, bad group. They said, I don't fear the hellfire. I don't have a hope for Jannah. Only I worship Allah because I love Him. I love Him. Some of the group exist until now. They say in aqidah, their faith, you shouldn't be fear from the hellfire. You shouldn't be hope for Jannah. Only you should worship Allah because you love Him. mashallah, philosophies. They try to philosophize the Islam according their mind. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the anbiya, وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَحَبًا. They used to ask and supplicate to us, hoping that we're from Allah and fearing from the punishment of Allah. So the sifatul khawfi wal-raja, it's a wings for the believer. He fly with two wings. He always in the hope of the mercy of Allah and hope of Jannah of Allah. And the same times, he's in fear of Allah and fear from the hellfire and fear from the punishment of Allah. This is a true believer should fly with two wings. If a person you see him, or a lady you see her, she has so much hope that she do all type of sin and said, oh Allah, Ghafoor Rahim, you should to tell her about some fear. Little, she need a medicine. She has to understand the punishment of hellfire is extremely hot. It's over our imagination. Then when you warn her, she will be digest or adjust. If a person, he is so much fear and is so much terror and he lost the hope, he said, Allah will punish me, Allah will not forgive me because I am so much sinner. No, here, no brother, don't say that. Allah, why his mercy wider than anything. You, the mercy of Allah over your imagination. So here we give him the right medicine, him or her or yourself. Sometimes we need that medicine to ourselves. If I have so much hope, I have to listen to some of the lectures and listen such as this, Al-Khawfu Min Al-Nar. Because the brothers and sisters, what for? We attend many classes. We hear about fiqh and hadith and aqidah and all these lessons. But it doesn't appear on our character, the character of the people of Jannah. MashaAllah, I have so much knowledge in fiqh, but I don't have fearness from the hellfire. I don't have awareness from the hellfire. I don't have the character of the people of Jannah. What for? So we need that reminder time to time. We need this reminder time to time in order to do something better in dunya. At least we achieve in Jannah. Ya Rabbal Alam, nas'al Allah an yudkhilana al-Jannah wa yajirana min an-nar. And this is not only me or something, that is the sunnah of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He used to stand and give khutbah. Do you believe that Aisha radiallahu anha, I think Aisha or one of the wife of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, she said, we memorize Surah Qaf from the mouth of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam because he used to use it during his khutbatul Jum'ah. And Surah Qaf, if you read it, wallahi, shake your heart. All talking about the situation and the moment in the next life, in the hereafter, about the Jannah, about the hellfire, about all this situation. So why Nabi Sallam used to give khutbah and deliver to the people in order to wake up? To wake up, to remind themselves. We need to remind ourselves time to time. We don't want to live in life, mashallah, it's okay, it's all right. Don't mention to me the hellfire, let me enjoy. No, we should remind yourself. You should to give some little wake up, awakening to your sense, awakening to your mind that the punishment of hellfire is really extremely hot. Be away from it. Step yourself away from it, run away from it. And run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seek the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the verses here we share with you in the board, Surah Al-Furqan, ayah number 63, qala ta'ala, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا.
The servants of the most merciful are those who walk upon the earth easily, and when the ignorant address them harshly, they say words of peace.
So in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described that attribute and the character of Ibadur Rahman, the servants of Ar-Rahman, the merciful, and that their character. Okay, this is the beginning of the verse. الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. They were very humble, very humble. They are aware from proudness and proudness and show off. Okay, what is the next character? والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما.
And those who spend part of the night to their Lord prostrating and standing in prayer.
And this is showing the importance of Qiyam al-Layl, and we spoke about it in the last series or last parts of the people of Jannah. So let's find out here. This verse is referred to our topic. Let's find out what is the character of the people of Jannah. They will say, وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا إِنَّهَا سَاءَتْ مُسْتَقَرًّا وَمُقَامًا.
And those who say, Our Lord, avert from us the punishment of hell. Indeed, its punishment is ever adhering.
So there's, look their character. رَبَّنَا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ. Oh, our Lord, oh Allah, اصْرِفْ عَنَّا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ. Avert from us the punishment of hellfire. Abandon us from the punishment of hellfire. Save us from the punishment of the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Inna azabaha kana gharama. It's extremely hot, extremely pain. So that their character. That is the character of the people of Jannah. They used to ask Allah, supplicate to Allah. And from now on, remember, brothers and sisters, at least minimum, you do seeking refuge by Allah from the hellfire and from the punishment of hellfire at least 3 times a day. What you should say? Allahumma ajirni minan nar. Allahumma ajirni minan nar. Allahumma ajirni minan nar. If you are asking for yourself, if we are a group, we will say Allahumma ajirna minan nar. Allahumma ajirna minan nar. Allahumma ajirna minan nar. Why? Because the hellfire will ask Allah and say, Ya Allah, your servant seeking refuge by you from me, oh Allah, save that person from me. The hellfire will talk to Allah. Oh Allah, save that person from me. May Allah save us from the punishment of the hellfire. A question. What is that question? Why the people of Jannah? They used to be in dunya. They have the character. They were in fear from the hellfire. Why? The answer is, we will divide it by point. The first point, because they understood very well that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning them from the punishment of the hellfire. Qala ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning them from the punishment of the hell fire. Qala ta'ala, ba'da a'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ عَلَيْهَا مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. Oh who believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to you. So what you should do? Give attention. Open your ear and say, Ya Allah, you calling me one of the best attribute, al-Iman. The character of al-Iman. Ya Allah, yes. What do you want from me? Qu anfusakum. This is a fi'lu amr. Fi'l amr. It's an order verb. Qu. save. Qu from wiqaya, from safety. Qu save yourself and your family. Save yourself and your family from the hellfire. وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning us about the punishment of hellfire, that the fuel of the hellfire is the people and the stone. The fuel of the hellfire will be the people and the stone. A'udhu billah. May Allah save us and not make us as a fuel for the hellfire. That our body become a fuel for the hellfire. Fuel and burn ourselves. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد. Angels, hardened angels, tough angels. No mercy on them. They will punish hardly and deeply. Hardly and deeply. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. I remember the people in hellfire, they will call 1,000 years. Not one time, not two times, not three times. 1,000 years calling. Ya Malik, Ya Malik, Ya Malik, liyaqdi alayna rabbuk. Oh Malik, let us die. Let Allah make us destroyed and finished. No more life. Take out the life from us. Then, after 1,000 years, what do you know, Malik? What reply to the people of hellfire? Qala innakum makithun. He will say, you will be remain. You will be remain. Ya Allah. Ya Allah, extremely pain. They calling, 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 calling. After 1,000 years, they are waiting for the answer, and the answer will be negative. You will be remain. This is make them more pain than the pain they are in it. When you call a person, and after many times, you might get a hope. So there is no hope for them to come out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Point number two. The people of Al-Jannah, they used to be afraid and aware from the hellfire, because the hellfire is very pain. Very, very pain. قال تعالى وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ. The one his deeds very light, خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُ, not enough in the scale. His أعمال, his deeds is very light, and the bad deeds is heavier. فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. His permanent destination for that person is the hellfire. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ. What is that hellfire? نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ. حَامِيَة, it's very extremely hot. حَامِي mean very, very, very hot. Very, very extremely hot. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the punishment of the hellfire. Also Allah says in Surah Al-Hajj, ayah number 19, to ayah number 22. From 19 to 22, قال تعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هذان خصمان اختصموا في ربهم فالذين كفروا قطعت لهم ثياب من نار يصب من فوق رؤوسهم الحميم يصهر به ما في بطونهم والجلود. ولهم مقامع من حديد. هذان خصمان اختصموا في ربهم فالذين كفروا, the disbeliever, قطعت لهم ثياب من نار. They will be given to them, they will give will be given to them ثياب, mean garment or cloth, from the hellfire. يصب من فوق رؤوسهم الحميم, from the over their head will be حميم. حميم is like a boiling water. That water reached the maximum in the heat. يصب من فوق رؤوسهم الحميم. When that water, the boiling one, the heat one, the hot one, very hot, boiling one, will be put in over their head, يصهر به ما في بطونهم والجلود. Whatever inside organ, from stomach, and all the organ, internal organ, will be melt. So the, can you imagine the boiling water from over their head, and the, whatever in their stomach will be melt. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. ولهم مقامع من حديد. مقامع mean face made from iron. So their face will be that iron will be put in their face. So, can you imagine if the iron, if it's extremely hot, what will happen? And that iron will be put in their face, وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, may Allah save us, and remain in their face, burning their face, over burning. كُلَّمَا أَرَادُ أَن يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا أُعِيدُ فِيهَا. Every time they're trying to come out from the hellfire, they will be returned back to it. Ya Allah, this is from Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us and describe to us how will be the punishment of the kuffar, of the disbeliever, whom deny Allah, who deny the next life, who is out of faith, who are doing evil deeds. How they will be, their situation in hellfire is extremely over our imagination. This is punishment. Subhanallah, I remember I memorize this surah, alhamdulillah, and maqami', maqami' mean cover face by iron. I used to come across the ayah with normal reflection, until one time I watched a tube. They have some items they used to use it in the olden days to punish who is in jail. One of that head made out of iron, they will put over the person and they will tight it, locked, so he cannot see, only a little hole to see from the small gap, and that iron will be remain sometimes for long. They punish that person by using this extremely punishment. When I see it, oh God, in my imagination, oh my God, if that covered for 2-3 months, the skin will be, what will happen to the skin? When I see it, I remember the verse, then my mind is broke. Oh Allah, what an amazing punishment. And that only iron, how about that iron with fire? نسأل الله العفو والعافية. And garment from fire. وَالْحَذُ بِاللَّهِ, may Allah save us. Something we should always be aware and afraid from that punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. So the people of Jannah, they understood that Allah described the hellfire extremely hot, extremely pain. So we have to be aware and we have to be fear. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم in the hadith, يؤتى بأنعم أهل الدنيا من أهل النار يوم القيامة. In the day of judgment, they will be brought up. Will be brought up a person whom the most joyful life he used to have in dunya, the highest person who had enjoyment in the dunya, enjoyment, enjoyable life, subhanallah, he has palace, castles, BMW, I don't know what cars, how many servants, he never had a disease or sickness or pain, he's whatever he wants, he just point. He doesn't need to order. He enjoys so much. He will be brought up and will be, what do you call it, dipped in hellfire. One dip is like as you get the biscuit and put it inside the chocolate and you take out. So he will be dipped in the hellfire. And after that, the angels will ask him, have you ever had a good time? He will say, I never had good time in my life. In one dip, he forget all the 60 or 80 or 90 or years he was enjoying in it. He was a maybe king. Subhanallah. And in Yawm Al-Qiyamah, they will be brought a person, he was the most hard life he had. Maybe he has all type of diseases, sickness, pain, poorness, whatever you want to add. He was humiliated. He had horrible life. He will be brought and will be dipped in Jannah. And they will ask him, have you ever had a bad time? He will say, I never had bad time in my life. Ya Allah, a dip in Jannah, change my mind. Change my situation. A dip in hellfire changed my situation, changing my enjoyment. Something, it's extremely amazing. It's over our imagination. Again and again, I will repeat it. Subhanallah. Because we are talking about hadith and ayat. If we want to just think about it or analyze it, I cannot handle it. Ya Allah, Ya Rab, Nas'al Allah al-'afwa al-'afiyah. Another hadith, this hadith riwayat Muslim. What I'm telling you, wallahi, based of a hadith, authentic. It's not based of talking or writing saying by people. It's a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أهون أهل النار عذابا يوم القيامة لرجل يوضع في أخمص قدميه جمرتان يغلي منهما دماغه. Said the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said the lowest level in hellfire, a person will be brought to him two stones from hellfire. That two stones will be put underneath of his foot. So his brain will be boiling. Ya Allah, from the stone, from the feet, the head will boiling. Ya Allah, what an amazing, painful one. And he will think he's the highest level in punishment. And he doesn't know that he is the lowest person in punishment. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. Okay, point number three. أهل الجنة during the dunya time, they fear and afraid from the hellfire because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them about the screaming of the people of hellfire. They will be screaming. The people of hellfire will be screaming. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. What they will say and what they will ask. O son of Adam or daughter of Adam, are you willing to scream with them? Nobody wants. So wake up. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala in Al-Quran, in Surah Ghafir, in Surah Fatir, ayah number 36-37, قال تعالى والذين كفروا لهم نار جهنم لا يقضى عليهم فيموتوا ولا يخفف عنهم من عذابها كذلك نجزي كل كفور وهم يصرخون فيها ربنا أخرجنا ربنا أخرجنا نعمل صالحا غير الذي كنا نعمل أولم نعمركم ما يتذكر فيه من تذكر وجاءكم النذير فذوقوا فما للظالمين من نصير والذين كفروا لهم نار جهنم لا يقضى عليهم فيموتوا. The people of hellfire, they will be in hellfire, they will not die, they will not die out of fire. Every time they die, the life come back to them. Every time they die, the life come back to them. And every time their skin will melt, they will replace to new skin. So they will be in pain and punish repeatedly. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. ولا يخفف عنهم. The pain or the fire, they will not be reduced. They will not be reduced. Even خزنته جهنم ادعوا ربكم, the people of hell fire, they will talk to each other. They say, yeah, PO, oh, let's do something. What do we have to do? Let's ask for one day off. For one day off. They want only one day to have a rest. One day. لخزنة جهنم ادعوا ربكم. They said, oh, Malik. خزنة جهنم, who, what his name? The angel Malik. لخزنة جهنم ادعوا ربكم يخفف عنا يوما من العذاب. Ask your Lord, okay, يعني they told Malik, oh Malik, please ask your Lord to reduce, not even off. They did not ask for off day. They will ask only reducing one day. يخفف عنا يوما من العذاب. And look at the reply from Malik. He said, قال أولم تك تأتيكم رسلكم بالبينات. Is the messengers and the prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to you with the evidence and sign? قالوا بلى. Yes, we receive the message. قالوا بلى وما دعاء الكافرين إلا في ضلال. Their dua, they will be not accepted, they will be in missing, يعني they will be failed. Every time they do dua, they will be failed. Every time they ask to reduce, for reducing the reducing from the punishment of hellfire, that dua will not be accepted. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. Look at the next verse that is talking about how they will screamly calling. How they will be screamly calling. قال تعالى وهم يصطرخون فيها. يصطرخون فيها in Arabic word mean they crying loudly with a shouting. There is two type of crying. One person is crying, you know, softly. Nobody maybe recognize he's a crying. But there's another type of crying. This is when the person, he lost everything. When a person, he is little bit pain, he will cry. But when the person, he lost everything, everything, and he lost his mind out of the calamity, he will crying with a shouting. You know, crying with a shouting. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. And this is the word يصطرخون فيها. ربنا أخرجنا نعمل صالحا غير الذي كنا نعمل. يعني let us come out from hellfire and brought us to us back to dunya, and we will do better. We will do better. قال أولم نعمركم ما يتذكر فيه من تذكر وجاءكم النذير. We give you time, we give you life, and the nadir, the warner came to you, the evidence came to you, the signs of Allah came to you. فذوقوا فما للظالمين من نصير. The wrongdoer, they will not be, they will not have any helper. The wrongdoer, they will not get any helper. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. So it's a awakening. Whomever want to be saved from the hellfire, he should to have the attribute of the people of Jannah. And one of their attribute, they used to be fear and aware from the hellfire. So what we have to do? فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. run towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, run towards Him, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night that to save you from the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us, as in the ayah we mentioned to you, يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اصْرِفْ عَنَّا عَذَابَ جَهَنَّمْ إِنَّ عَذَابَهَا كَانَ غَرَامًا. Another verses also very touching, قَالَ تَعَالَى رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارَ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَهُ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ, indeed whomever enter the hellfire he will be in big lost. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ, and the wrongdoers they will not find any helper. They will used to ask Allah, Ya Allah, don't make us among them, don't put us with them, don't, Ya Allah, save us from punishment, from the hellfire. Also another verse, قَالَ تَعَالَى ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا, ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار, ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة, ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. Oh, what a touching dua between the servants to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this ayat, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time he stood all the night praying to Allah, repeating these verses. Inna fi khalqi samawati wal ardi, repeating the verses and crying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani a few ayat, it's only half page or one page. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, recited all the night. It's contained dua, talking how those people closer to Allah, and they were in fear from the hellfire. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to ask Allah, Allahumma inni as'aluka ridaka wal jannah wa a'udhu bika min sakhatika wal nar. Allahumma inni as'aluka ridaka wal jannah وَعَوْذُ بِكَ مِنْ سَخَطِكَ وَالنَّارِ. And this is hadith. Another dua, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say, اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار, وقنا عذاب النار. This some of the dua, always put it in your mind and say it day and night. Point number two, also run to do a good deed. Run to do the good deeds in order to be protect and save from the hellfire. Also be aware from the sin and shortcoming and major sin. So the true believer, they used to say, إني أخاف إن عصيت ربي عذاب يوم عظيم. Indeed, I am fear or scared that if I disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will be in the great punishment. عذاب يوم عظيم. Okay, great punishment, great punishment. So the believer always in fear and terror, okay, scared that from the punishment of the hellfire, and scared if he do this sin, he will be in hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us. So let's come to the conclusion for today, that the true believer should have fear. And the hadith of Rasulullah very clear that whomever in fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make give him the safety in next life. And the person he feels safe in dunya, he will be afraid and scared in the next life. So part of our faith and our character should have fearness from the punishment of Allah, fearness from the fire, fearness from Allah. Okay, so this is the conclusion of the lesson today. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us from the hellfire. And always, at least one time, once in a day at least, remember how great the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in hellfire. And then supplicate with emotional way. Not supplicate just, Allahumma ighfir li, Allahumma adkhilni jannah, and your mind different way. So let's, when you say, Ya Allah, save me from the punishment of hellfire, you understanding very well that the punishment of hellfire is it's over your mind from the punishment, from the heat, from the boiling, from the pain, from all these words. So when you have this in your mind, the dua will be very close to Allah, more sincere in it, more ikhlas, you know, more sincere. But a person, he said, just he memorized the dua, and some of the people just repeat the dua and without understanding what is the dua saying, and what is the contain, what is the meaning of the dua he's doing. So we have to understand to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we do dua. جزاكم الله خيرا وأحسن الله إليكم. نسأل الله أن يرحمنا ويعفو عنا ويدخلنا الجنة ويجيرنا من النار ويثبتنا على الصراط المستقيم ويعفو عنا ويرزقنا حسن الخاتمة ويدخلنا الجنة ويجيرنا من النار. آمين آمين يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. If any question, inshallah, you like to share, we are open, inshallah. Yes, sir.
You know, sometimes being a human being, we tend to do so many mistakes. There was one chapter of your life when you feel so close to Allah and you can cry. Even you don't really understand the verses, but you feel touched. But there comes a point when you have done so many mistakes and you can no longer feel. You try to feel, but you can no longer cry. Is there a remedy for that? How do you cleanse your heart in order for you to wake up for Qiyam again and things like that?
Basically what I understood from your question, sometimes you feel you are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're crying without controlling yourself, and sometimes you don't have that feeling. You don't have the feeling that you want to cry, even you hear some reminder or see something. That is showing that we always, the Muslims, always in different level of Iman and faith. Sometimes he in high state of faith and Iman and his heart very soft. Sometimes his Iman it's medium or low or weak or different level of Iman. When yourself feel hardened or your heart hardened, run to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Run to the ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to try to soften your heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Is the time come to those believers that their heart will تَخْشَع, they have khashya, they have a fearness, awareness, humbleness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ, and whatever revealed from the truth. So always you should be as like a station, petrol station. Fulfill your heart, test your heart, analyze your heart. When your heart become hardened, straight away run to the ways how to soften your heart again and again. And wherever you feel your Iman weak, try to run to do some of the ibadat, with the ta'a, with the istighfar, with the tawbah, with the reminder, to elevate your Iman, elevate your faith. Subhanallah. Then the heart come back again soft, and inshallah you will feel that you are more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So also I would like to mention very important point. Some of the people, they love Allah and they are closer to Allah and they are very mashallah religious. Certain period of time, suddenly he feel weak, very weak. I can't do Qiyam al-Layl, I can't do, you know, saying from remembering of Allah. I cannot have a strength to recite one juz from Al-Quran. I feel more weaker and weaker. Don't feel disappointed. That's a normal of human nature. As long you are remain in ibadah, as long you are remain in the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's a hadith qala likulli amalin shirrah. Every action or every deed has shirra, mean the time of active time. You are very active, you are mashallah very energetic to do. وَلِكُلِّ شِرَّةٍ فَتْرَةٍ, and every active time it has a weakness. Whomever his weakness, towards my sunnah, my way, he is in the guidance. Or he will be out of the guidance. So some people, less in Qiyam al-Layl, less in Ibadah, less. It's okay as long as he stay in Ibadah. Not come out from Ibadah. He said, I can't do this Islam. It's difficult, man, religion. I want to be free. I want to enjoy. Start dropping until he fall in the scene and he stop doing Ibadah to Ibadah and minimize it until he drop it. This person, he will be in misguidance. So be aware to be a part of the misguidance. If you are weak little bit, or weak, as long in the sunnah, doing all the farida, all the obligation, alhamdulillah, good. After certain time, you will come back again. Active, inshallah. So this is what we should do for the true believer. So if you feel little bit, sometimes weak, or you don't have that, the feeling, you cry straight away, it's normal. Because we are always changing. But make sure that you didn't fall in any sin that make your heart harden or make Allah angry from you. Then you want to cry, you want to do ibadah, and you cannot find it. This is a call, the result of the sin. The result of the sin sometimes make you away from Allah and make your heart harden, make you feel down, you make you unenergetic to do an ibadah. So this is they call the result of the sin. So test yourself. And sometimes if you cannot cry, try to cry. We always say it, if you cannot cry, I'm trying to do salah, my heart is not with me, trying to cry, slowly, then the fearness and the awareness, the khushu', the khashya, that all this meaning will come to you. So this is what we try to do with yourself. You always analyzing your heart. You always testing your heart. You always aware about your heart. So this is how the Muslim and the believer should be. And Allah knows the best. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the right understanding of the word of Allah and the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is it enough, sister? Inshallah, jazakumullah khair. Any other question? Barakallahu feekum. Barakallahu feekum. May Allah reward you. Jazakumullah khair. Wa ahsanallahu ilaykum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.